Lori Davis from the Springfield Department of Environmental Services is joining us this morning, and we are talking trash and specifically about how the garbage disposal is not a trash can. Lori, thank you so much for being here.
Thanks, Jennifer.
So some of the things you will be talking about, I have to tell you, I have been guilty of doing this, but we're learning today what we're not supposed to do. Several things, common items in the kitchen that we're putting down the garbage disposal that doesn't belong there. What are some of those items?
Right. So our garbage disposal tends to be a lot like our trash can. It's the throw it away and it's out of sight, out of mind. Then we forget that our garbage disposal is really the first line of defense in protecting our sewer system. And so I don't know about you, but I kind of like a working sewer system. So these are some of the common items, especially now around the holiday season or when we're doing cooking for families. We've got some things that, oh, I'll just toss that down the garbage disposal. Things like our eggshells. These don't sharpen the blades, contrary to popular belief.
So that's a myth. If you haven't heard that, it's not true.
Correct. And eggshells have a double whammy to them. Not only does the shell not then break down in the garbage disposal, but you've got that little membrane that can wrap around the blade, so it's not going to break down. A better use for that would be to just grind it down and add it to the soil in your garden to give your plants some extra nutrients. Coffee grounds are another one. I am a coffee drinker, but when these go down the garbage disposal, those grounds can clog up the system. And so we want to keep those out of our garbage disposal as well. Again, this is something that if you do home composting, these can be very easily added to the home composting bin. If you don't have that, put them into the trash can.
In the trash can. Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Flour is another one. Flour and pasta and rice, when it meets up with a liquid, it expands, it absorbs, and it creates a big cloggy mess down where you can't see it, down in your sewer system. And so that's another one that we want to keep out of the garbage disposal. Any leftover flour from your baking experiences, put them into the trash can.
Into the trash can. Yeah. And the last one is dairy products, milk.
Yeah.
What do we do with it then if it doesn't belong in the garbage disposal? And why not?
Well, as you can see in this bottle, our milk and dairy products, they coat, they coagulate, they clog up the system. And so they also add increased bacteria that it affects and impacts the wastewater treatment process once those dairy products get to the wastewater treatment plant. So we want to keep them out, just leave them in the container, toss them into the trash can, but definitely keep our dairy products out of the garbage disposal as well.
And Lori, you said there are other items as well. These are just some of the most common ones. If
yes.
people want to find out more about what we should not be putting down the garbage disposal, how do they do that?
They can visit our website at City of Springfield Environmental Services. You can look for other items, fibrous vegetables, bones, yeah. those kinds of peach pits.
All right, Lori Davis with the City's Environmental Services. Thank you so much for being here. We are talking trash with Lori, and the garbage disposal is not a trash can. We'll be right back with more right here on Daybreak.